Now, to go deeper and to better understand the selection process, I am pleased to welcome Dr. Vincent Jacquier, microbiology expert for Adisseo Research Center. Good morning, Dr. Jacquier.
Good morning, Stéphanie.
So you took part in Alterion development process. Mm-hmm. So can you explain us why the selection criteria that are quoted on the video, why are they so important?
Mm-hmm. Yes. So Bacillus subtilis are safe microorganisms. They are QPS and they are AFCO listed. In our screening process, one of our major criteria was safety, which means we need to make sure that candidate strain does not include resistant genes to antibiotic use in human medicines. But also the candidate strain should not be hemolytic nor cytotoxic. The authority do not request the absence of hemolysis, but for us it was a major criteria because, of course, it's very important for the safety of animals. Moreover, a good probiotic is a microorganism which germinates at the good place in the good time. Bacillus species, due to their capacity to sporulate, are very resistant to external aggression, so chemical or physical. As for example, it could be heat, it could be pressure, acidity, and so on. Thanks to this characteristic, Bacillus subtilis are able to resist to pelting condition, but also to gastric condition environment. Despite these properties, all the Bacillus species and strains don't show the same capacity to resist to stress. So in our screening process, we selected strains with the best resistant features.
Okay, so that explains safety and robustness, but what about bringing gut health to the animal?
Yes, so in fact, maintaining and improving gut health are key concerns for us. Mm-hmm. That's why we selected a strain which do not increase inflammation at intestinal level and which can even have anti-inflammatory property effects in stressed conditions. So finally, we selected some strains which were tested in vivo trials, in standard, but also in challenging conditions. As for an example, in induced necrotic enteritis model, knowing that necrotic enteritis is one of the major problems in field today.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Jacquier, for this explanation.